Richard Stillman and Kelly Ripa.
It's Monday, September 24th, 2007. Don't know if you saw the show on Friday, but guess who won a couple of Emmys?
Really?
Right there, baby.
Really?
Rellies.
We don't need no stinking Emmy, because we've got Rellies.
And we don't get any stinking Emmy either.
We can't lose. Oh. It's an award show set up so that even we can't lose. That's right.
Well, what a weekend I had.
Tell me everything. I know that you had to inspire.
I went out to change, you know, the scene at Notre Dame to inspire the team to their first victory this season.
Correct, sir.
Yeah.
How'd you do?
You don't know?
I don't know.
Well, then you're in for a treat. Let me
okay,
tell you.
Okay, good. Take me through it. I try not to pay attention because I want you to surprise me with your story.
Well, I appreciate that. Well, you know, I went to the pep rally at Notre Dame.
I know.
Yeah, I told you that. And I got some pictures here to show you.
Oh, my God.
Now, here we are. Here's Regis and Coach Charlie Weiss.
Very nice.
Getting ready to go out
and
do
it. And by the way, Reg, I like that look. I like the checkered shirt.
Well, I thought, you know, it's kind of a relaxed thing.
Masculine,
it was kind of
warm. Sexy, yet understated.
It's exactly what four football players said to me, you know. Here I am whispering to Charlie, giving him last-minute advice before the big game against Michigan State. Pretty good football players. The leprechaun was there, a happy leprechaun. And the kids were playing the band. The band was absolutely fabulous. Regis made jokes about Coach's haircut. Even got a smile out of Coach.
Oh, this is the part where you bring him home. Bring him home, Big Daddy, bring him home.
You're something.
I can tell.
I was telling them a little personal story about what happened to me, what kind of changed my life. You know, I think I may have told you this, but all through high school, all through Notre Dame, all through the service, I never pursued anything that might lead me to this position, which is really what I wanted to be in life, you know, be on television. But I never thought I had any talent. Really still don't.
But that didn't stop you.
Well, but that worried me whether I was going to waste my life trying and never make it. And so... I was at the Naval Amphibious Base in Coronado when I was wrapping up my service career. And on the day I was leaving, there was a knock on the door. And I had befriended two majors on the base, two Marine majors. And one of them was a very, very tough guy. Both of them were tough, but this guy was really a killer. You know, people shied away when they saw him. But he came into my room and he said, "Understand you're leaving." I said, "Yes, sir, I am." He said, "Well, what are you going to do with your life?" And I had never told anybody. I really want to go on television. I wasn't going to tell him. I was afraid of him.
Right.
So I said, "Well, I think I, you know what, I'm not sure." He said, "Well, what do you want to do with your life?"
Right.
I said, I want to be on television, but I don't think I can make it. Well, you know, these Marines are tough guys.
Right.
And this guy went right up to me like this, this far away from me.
Yes.
And he said, "Don't you know you can have anything you want in this life? You've only got to want it bad enough. Now, do you want it?" I still couldn't say, "Yes,
yes,
I want
sir.
It. Do you want it?" he says. I said, "Yes, sir, I want it." I got in the car, went up to Hollywood, made a contact, and then 3 months later, the guy called me, gave me a job as a stagehand.
Incredible.
So I told that story. And I told it only because I felt Notre Dame is at the